A lot of guys like you and me are concerned with muscle building next to health, and we are often advised to eat still a big meal before going to bed, long protein like casein and maybe carbs even. So the question comes back regularly, will eating carbs before bed lower your growth hormone production? Because growth hormone is very important for overall health and muscle building. So
yeah.
This is the TRT and Hormone Optimization YouTube channel. And if you want to learn all about the science-based information on this topic, consider subscribing, hit that notification bell, and you'll be on your way.
So this is an interesting question. You have two worlds of thought here. You have the bodybuilder at a high level, and I say high level because some of the amateurs don't really need to worry about this. High level meaning like your big, you know, 270, 300-pound guys that compete. And the reason I put them in a separate class because those guys use super physiological level of somatropin, which is a synthetic growth hormone, and they're going to use them at very high levels. I'm talking 15, 18, 20, 23 IUs per day. A, very expensive. B, very dangerous. It will cause type 2 diabetes. It will require insulin, and it is going to cause organomegaly, cardiomegaly, and other implications, which are not recommended. Putting those guys aside and speaking to the masses, growth hormone, for the most part, is not as anabolic as people make it out to be when it comes to therapeutic or anti-aging doses. Spiking your IGF-1, which is released by the liver upon growth hormone production at the pituitary level, is something that is primarily going to benefit you in a number of factors. Muscle building is not necessarily one of them. Most guys who use a somatropin synthetic recumbent growth hormone are going to use about 2 IUs per day. And that is going to be before bedtime. And what I personally like, and I know we made a video about this, is more so the growth hormone releasing peptides and hormones and secretagogues, which are going to help produce more endogenous growth hormone release and therefore elevate IGF-1. Those are not going to suppress your own production. Those are actually going to synergistically impact your own natural production, which is a nice feature to have. And it mitigates any potential risks or side effects. With that said, we know that insulin is antagonistic to IGF-1. So naturally, if you're going to eat carbohydrates before bed, which there is a time and place for, especially if you are bulking, right? And you're going to eat some carbs before bed, maybe, as you said, with some casein protein, both protein and carbohydrates will essentially elevate insulin level, which suppresses IGF. Yes, your growth hormone production may be suppressed somewhat. And the only thing that is going to do is not inhibit muscle growth, especially when you're in a caloric surplus and you're training accordingly. What it may do is kind of nullify some, a little bit, of the growth hormone benefits, which will include better quality REM sleep, or more hours of deep sleep, clearer skin, better hair, better nails. Okay, so these are all rejuvenation type of cellular functions. It is by no means going to impede your muscle growth. In fact, I would argue that eating sufficient protein distribution, enough carbohydrates to promote glycogen stores in muscle tissue for those who train with resistance type training like weightlifting, as well as staying in a caloric surplus, will build more muscle faster and more efficiently than missing meals, going to bed hungry, not providing protein for a period of 12 hours and going into a low blood glucose level than just using a growth hormone at a low dose before bed. So I wouldn't put too much stock into should I not eat before bed if your goal is to build muscle. You should certainly eat your meals. You should certainly have protein in your system at all times, because remember, you're not building muscle in the gym. You're breaking down fibers. You're causing damage. You're causing a catabolic response. The anabolic response and the repair comes in your sleep. And if you don't provide your body the nutrients needed for that protein synthesis, which the whole point of your testosterone in the bodybuilding arena is to increase the amount of protein synthesis you're capable of producing. If you do not provide the nutrients required for this process over the time period that your body goes to work on it, you're essentially going to wake up sore, you're going to be fatigued, you're going to get injured over time, and you're not going to get the most out of your workouts and recovery. So I would say priority number one, make sure that your nutrition and training are on par. Priority number two, don't worry about the growth hormone before bed if you're bulking. When you're cutting, you're already in a caloric deficit. If you want to go to bed without the carbs, not a problem. You want to run the growth before bed and or before fasted cardio in the morning. Again, you're looking to slim out, you're looking to reduce mass and just hold on to as much muscle as you can at that point. Muscle building phase, get in your calories, make sure they're appropriate, and don't worry so much about the IGF-1 at that point. And testosterone in and of itself will elevate IGF-1 anyways. So not really something that I would worry about as a layman person trying to put on a couple extra pounds.
Mm-hmm. If you produce most of your growth hormone at night while you're sleeping, why wouldn't, if you do an extra for health reasons, why wouldn't you inject the growth hormone in the morning or take the secretagogues in the morning then?
That is a good question. So the theory behind that, I assume, is, well, I'm already going to have my natural endogenous production at night. How do I continue this chain when it actually drops? First and foremost, you have to consider the growth hormone has implications outside of just the benefits. It does cause fatigue. It will make you tired. Okay, so if you're going to use growth hormone in the morning, as we often did in prep when we were competing, for the sake of doing, 40 minutes on the bike to burn more fat, we're going to be a little lethargic, throughout the day. And then remember, as soon as you go in and eat your meal, your insulin spikes and you're suppressing that IGF-1 anyway. So you're kind of fighting against it. But I found that guys that will, this is, purely anecdotal because it's just, guys that I've coached over the years, myself included, guys that use the growth hormone or analogs in the morning are going to find that they're going to be more fatigued throughout the day than guys who just use it before bedtime. So I know guys that use morning and night, but again, if you're using somatropin, you're suppressing your own production. So if you're using the synthetic, it's not like you're going to be peaking at night. If you're using the secretagogues, yeah, you'll have your own production at night. You're going to go back and use it again in the morning. You're going to feel some fatigue, which is why they released the fragmented 1-29. It's the first 29 amino chains of the 191 aminos involved in the growth hormone molecule, because these are, they found, are the ones that are responsible for fat loss, but they do not spike IGF-1. So you can actually use those in the morning before fasted cardio without the increased fatigue for the day. And then you can go back to the full molecule in the evening to get the benefits of IGF-1 and improved sleep. So that is a two-tiered approach for people that are looking for the fasted cardio AM and then the full growth hormone in the evening.
Very interesting. Thank you. I learned a ton. Thanks, Gil.
My pleasure.
Hey, and now do this next. Click on one of these thumbnails to learn a ton more about TRT and hormone optimization. Thank you.